Everybody likes to say, well, Jeet Kune Do is just Western fencing, boxing, and this, you know, and Wing Chun. It's the commonalities between them, not this art, this art, this art.
A specific thing about the original guys that were around Bruce Lee, you know, like, Dan Inosanto is obviously, and I have a lot of respect for Dan Inosanto. I'm going to say that on record. I think Dan Inosanto has done a lot of good for martial arts and brought Jeet Kune Do to the forefront. But I think that there's misconceptions from some of the people that really follow Dan Inosanto to the letter and to the core, where his personal martial arts journey became Jeet Kune Do. Like certain things that perhaps, and that happens in every martial art, first of all, but it happened really hardcore. And people just started doing what, let's say, Dan Inosanto was doing on a personal level and calling that Jeet Kune Do. And that became a little air of confusion. Can we just rewind, get to that, and we'll slowly move forward?
The main fact is that a lot of people mistake, you know, Dan's personal martial evolution as Jeet Kune Do, right? Versus Bruce's martial evolution. And their paths, while they're, you know, they're together on some things, they diverge dramatically on other things. Whatever he would absorb was to end up with a single cohesive art, not a group of separate different arts. Whatever was brought in, again, was absorbed into that structure.
You would always tell me as a young man training, and you say it in almost every seminar, there's elements of boxing in Jeet Kune Do, but you are not a boxer. There's elements of Wing Chun, but you're not a Wing Chun man. Can you just clarify that for the audience? Like, what do you mean by that?
As Bruce was evolving and he's investigating these other avenues, he looks at Western boxing. There are things he liked about it. There are things that he didn't like about it. While it has elements that he wanted or that he liked, there are elements he didn't. So he didn't take everything from boxing, because you don't think that structure. You think, what is your structure?
They want to put Jeet Kune Do in a nice little bow and package so that they can sell certifications online and go do a seminar and go, set one, set two, set three. Here's our boxing section. Here's our kickboxing section. And I think that there's a good thing in organizing things and making things neat, but I think it limits the art. Like, for instance, I always loved Jeet Kune Do because of what you just said. It didn't limit my elements of combat, but didn't limit my thought.
You know, again, it goes back to his mind, how his mind thinks about this stuff. He's working out how I can make myself stronger, how I can make myself more powerful doing that. Not just, I'm going to stay in this.